I'm so bummed. When I was editing the video, for some reason, the microphone glitched out during that conversation with Chance, so we missed the whole thing. So basically what I was telling Chance is I was giving him one of my favorite analogies for explaining the role of your core in our athletes' bodies. Okay, so I gave him the soda can analogy. So basically, if I were to pull out a full can of soda out of the refrigerator and hand it to you, could you crush it with one hand? The answer is probably no, right? But as soon as you crack the tab, even if you crack it just a little bit, you can crush the whole can with one hand, okay? And the reason for that is there's a compromise in the structure of the can that allows the whole thing just to collapse, okay? So earlier in the video, you saw me kind of correcting Chance's core during his split stance with a one-arm press. That's because when I was watching him, he was kind of wiggling as he was pressing, okay? So that tells me that there's an energy leakage in his core. As he tries to produce force with his upper body, that energy does not transfer through his core into the ground correctly and efficiently. So we're kind of tightening up that can, that soda can, getting rid of any leaks and making sure that that can does not collapse. Okay? So as a basketball player, he's producing a lot of force into the ground to get up for rebounds and to get up to a shot. We don't want his core to be the limiting factor as he presses all that force into the ground trying to get up, that his core kind of collapses. Okay? So it's just an efficiency thing, but that's the analogy that I like to use. Unfortunately, we didn't capture the audio in that little conversation, but that's basically the gist.